Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sapaha. This is the fifth part of my series, Significant Provisions for Women in the Indian Legal System. This particular series is the detail of the provisions and laws related to property for women. The first one is right to an equal share in inheritance. This is very important because before 2005, the girl was not considered as a co-partner in Hindu family property. But after 2005, many amendment has been done under Section 6 of the Hindu Succession Act, in which many provision has been added for female. The first one is now the female is a co-partner of Hindu family property. That means a girl child is having an equal right on her father's property by birth. And if there is a partition going on after the death of her father, then there will be an equal share of her in her father's property. Secondly, any female member of the family can demand or seek for partition of the dwelling house where the family resides. That means in the house also or in the home also, she is having an equal right. Then third one is a widow of a predeceased son, even though she is remarried now, eligible for share in property as legal heir of the predeceased son of the family. That means if by any chance husband dies, then also widow is having an equal share of her husband as a legal heir in the family, even if she got remarried. Then the last one is a female can also dispose of her share in co-partner's property at her own will. That means she is having a full control on her property. Next is Stridhan. Now Stridhan is that type of property in which a woman is having an exclusive control. Now what does Stridhan means and what includes under Stridhan? Basically, whatever gifts at the time of marriage a father or a parents are giving to the bride and also the relatives of the parents are giving to the bride are considered as a Stridhan. Similarly, whatever gift a lady or a bride is getting after marriage by her husband and the relatives of the husband are considered as Stridhan. That means, in a simple manner, whatever gift out of love and affection a female is getting at the time of her marriage by her parents' side and by her in-law side are considered as Stridhan and she is having exclusive control over it. And if anyone in the husband house is not giving her that property, she can demand for it. Next is right in husband's property. Now this particular thing is majorly related to a widow. According to Section 10 of Hindu Succession Act, the distribution of property takes place among all heir including deceased widow. That means a wife is entitled to an equal share of her husband's property like the other surviving entitles. And secondly, if by chance there is no sharer, that means there is no other heir of her husband's property, then she is having a full right to inherit the entire property of her deceased husband. Next is right over her individual property. Now it means a married woman also has exclusive rights over her individual property, which includes all the assets, whether they are earned, inherited, or gifted. Now she is also entitled to maintenance, support, and shelter from her husband. And if there is a joint family, then this liability goes to the joint family. Next is absolute property. Now what does absolute property means? Although she is having Stridhan, she is also an owner of her individual property, but there are something which is absolute property, which has been mentioned under Section 14 of Hindu Succession Act. Now, any property possessed by a Hindu female, whether it is acquired before or after the commencement of this act, this is important, before and after the commencement of this act, shall be held by her as full owner thereof and not as a limited owner. That means she is entitled for all the property even before and after the commencement of this act. Now, what does property means? Which type of property are included in this? This includes both movable and immovable property which is acquired by a female Hindu by inheritance or device. Secondly, or at a partition, or in a lieu of maintenance, or arrears of maintenance, or by gift from any person, whether a relative or not, before, at, or after her marriage, that means gift, with or by her own skill or exertion, or by purchase or by prescription, or in any other manner whatsoever, and also any such property held by her as Stridhan immediately before the commencement of this act. That means a female is an absolute owner of her property, no matter the before or after the commencement of the act. But still, there is some exception of this section, and that is nothing contained in subsection 1, that which has been stated, shall apply to any property acquired by way of gift or under a will or any other instrument, or under a decree or order of a civil court, or under an award where the terms of gift, will, or other instrument, or the decree, order, or award prescribe a restricted estate in such property. That means if by any chance, although by gift or by will, or by any other instrument, that means maybe by the decree of the court, if these things are having some sort of restriction, then it is not an absolute property. Otherwise, it is an absolute property of a woman. Next is right to maintenance or alimony by the husband. Now, before starting the right to maintenance and alimony by the husband, let me tell you the meaning of maintenance and what includes under maintenance. Basically, the things which are included under maintenance are food, shelter, education, clothing, and medical treatment. This has been based on the ground of many judgments. Again, I repeat, food, shelter, education, clothing, and medical treatment. These are things which is included under maintenance. Now, maintenance has been described under three acts in India. The first one is Section 18 of Hindu Marriage, Adoption and Maintenance Act, 1956. Basically, under this act, a Hindu wife is entitled to claim a maintenance from her husband in case she is seeking for the divorce, and on the following grounds. The first ground is if the husband is guilty of cruelty. Now, cruelty may be a physical cruelty, emotional cruelty, or a mental cruelty. Second is desertion. Desertion means if the husband has left her and not keeping her with him, then it is called as desertion. Third is polygamy. Polygamy when he has already married. That means he has done a second marriage without leaving her. Leaving her means without giving her divorce. Then it comes under polygamy. And lastly, when he is having a venereal disease. Now, under these grounds, a female can seek for the divorce, and she can also file for maintenance or alimony by the husband under Section 18 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, 1956. Next is interim maintenance or pendant right. Now, pendant light has been described under Section 24 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Let me tell you, this particular section is for husband and wife, for both. Whoever is not independent or whoever is much needy. If by any chance a divorce is going on in the court and anyone, maybe a husband or a wife, is not able to survive or for the livelihood, and they are not even able to pay the court fees or any other expenses of the legal proceeding, then under Section 24 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955, they can demand for pendant light. Now, that pendant light include not only the livelihood, the amount or expenses of livelihood, but also the expenses of all the court proceeding. Now, this expenses, the amount of this expenses is decided or by the court, and it is purely the discretion of the court that what should be the amount of pendant light. Next is permanent alimony. Now, permanent alimony has been described under Section 25 of the Hindu Marriage Act 1955, which provides permanent alimony or a maintenance to the wife and children in case the husband and wife continue to live separately, irrespective of the fact whether their divorce petition has been accepted or rejected. Then also there can be a demand or there will be a permanent alimony. And the last type of maintenance is Section 125 of CRPC. Now, Section 18 of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act and Section 24 and 25 of Hindu Marriage Act, both are related to only Hindu women. What about the Muslim, Christian, or any other religion who are a part of India? Now, looking of these problem, Section 125 is of CRPC is a secular provision which is governing the maintenance of law across all personal law, which states that if any person having a sufficient income and means refuses to maintain the wife who is incapable of maintaining herself sufficiently and brings about an application for the same, then the magistrate hearing the divorce case upon being made aware of such refusal or neglect must award a monthly allowance for maintenance for the wife. That means if a wife is not independent, no matter she is of any other religion, the only condition is she has to be Indian or an Indian resident. Then she can demand for the maintenance of not only for her, but also for her children. The magistrate may award any amount which he deems fit to paid monthly in such time interval as directed by the magistrate. This is the provision of Section 125 of Criminal Procedure Code in India. So this is all about the property rights and the fifth part of my video series, Significant Provisions for Women in Indian Legal System. Hope you like it. And if you like it, please do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. And if you want the detailed notes, you may visit to my website, that is priyasipaha.com. And you may also follow me on FB page and Instagram as Law Colloquy, and on Twitter, that is Dr. Priya Sipaha. Thank you for watching. I hope you like it. See you soon. Bye-bye.